Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Soccer with Tato. Today we're going to be talking about what is called in America, soccer around the world, better known as football.
Yes,
the real football. We're going to be demonstrating using a basketball though. Just for the sake of it, I thought it was better to inform you. My guest today is Kiara. Kiara, how are you doing today?
I'm doing fine. I'm ready to learn.
Okay. I'm going to teach you a little bit about the beautiful game.
Okay, I'm ready.
Football is a game that started a long time ago. A very long time ago. It has lasted almost 100 years, mm-hmm. and it has seen many greats. Amongst them, Pelé of Brazil, Maradona of Argentina, Ronaldinho of Brazil, Ronaldo of Brazil, Samuel Eto'o of Cameroon, and why not London Donovan of the United States of America. This game has had a lot of impact in our society, mm-hmm. In every way, both in the physique of people being the only sport that really does increase a person's sexual libido by 100%.
Really?
And also financially by guaranteeing people who grew up in poor regions with the talent to be able to make something of themselves. All right, so the game is played with 22 players in total on the field of play. It has a goalkeeper who guards the pole.
Mm-hmm.
We normally refer to that position as the number one position. It has a fullback, a left fullback, whom we refer to as in the three position. We have a defender who goes into the midfield and comes back. That's the four position. And then we have the five position, which is a defender, a central defender. He stays right there. And the four actually make certain that nobody is attacking him at any time because he's the last line of defense.
Right.
Then we have the two position, who is also another fullback, who can climb at any time to help the attack or the midfield and come right back. At the midfield position, we have the six, who is a defensive midfielder. His job is to help the defenders in order to maintain security on the pole, and also to distribute the ball to the midfielders. Then we have the eight, who is purposely, solely a distributor.
Okay.
Like what you would call the quarterback.
Okay.
In American football.
Right.
But I must let you know that that game should not really be called football, because the only reason why it's called football is because the ball is 1 foot long.
Really, I didn't.
Yeah,
know
it's not.
That.
It's not because they play the game with the feet. Of course, they run with it and
right.
all of that. All right. On the left side of the attacking side, you got 11. It's called the 11th position, who runs the ball and tries to feed the central attackers or scores himself. And then you got the 10, who is a playmaker.
Mm-hmm.
He receives the ball from the midfield. He tries to make sure that he distributes it or passes it such that it gets to the striker, who is the nine. He's the main person responsible for a goal. Anybody on the field of play can score. Anybody on the field of play can score, but there is one person solely responsible for scoring. Just like in basketball, you have the point guard, right?
Mm-hmm.
So the nine is responsible solely for scoring
okay.
the ball.
Okay.
We have the seven, who also plays the same role as the 11.
Mm-hmm.
He distributes the ball and he can also score. Do you understand all of this?
I think so.
Okay, in order to better your understanding,
mm-hmm.
we're going to do a little demonstration.
Okay.
Right.
Okay.
Okay. So, I am the distributor of the ball.
Okay.
Say, if I pass you the ball, what I'm looking for is for you to pass me the ball. But I do not want you to pass the ball directly to me. I want you to watch where I'm going so that you can pass the ball right there.
Okay.
So say I'm passing you the ball while you're standing right there.
Okay.
And you see me running this way. Where are you going to pass the ball?
That way.
Good. So if I pass you the ball, say this way. Well, you pass the ball.
I'm going to pass the ball that way.
And I take it and try to distribute it. That's how the game works. It's a very exciting game. It really brings it. It's a lively game.
It's a lot of running.
Yeah, it's a lot of running.
I'm kind of out of shape.
But that makes you get in shape, of course. So I would recommend
that
everybody should try to at least allow their kids to try it. You know what I mean? Yeah. Football has been in the world for a long time, like I said.
Mm-hmm.
It has brought a lot of great players. But the one thing that I'd like our audience to understand is that it's been very popular, increasingly popular in the United States.
Yeah.
Especially for the women. The American state has had the greatest achievement in the world of football when it comes to female football.
Okay.
Yes. They have won the World Cup the greatest number of times. The sport is growing in the United States. But we refuse to call it by its name, in a way. Call it soccer because of football. So, little girls go to school and they learn how to play this football and we encourage them to play. So why do we not encourage little boys to play it as well as we encourage girls? I really do not know. Because I'm from Africa, and I know that I've played this game since I was born.
Right.
Yes, my father played football. My brothers played football.
Mm-hmm.
I played football. As a matter of fact, my little brother almost went professional.
Really?
Yes. So, as an American,
okay,
born in America, what is your input on the reason why?
I would probably say maybe football or basketball is seen as a little bit more masculine. It was probably here first.
Okay.
Then soccer, it was an older sport, so people really got into that. I know what baseball is the oldest sport in America, I believe.
Yes.
But I would say football and basketball and baseball is probably more popular than soccer.
I tell you something. I watched a movie a long time ago. It was probably like the first movie I ever watched, 1990. I was 8 years old. That was my first World Cup, by the way, that I watched in Italy at 90. Coming to America.
Okay.
A great movie.
Yeah.
And then Akeem, who played by Edimofi, the popular Edimofi, came from Africa, of course, and they went to this basketball field together with Lisa's boyfriend, who was very, 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 in my opinion, enthusiastic and very, very.
Mm-hmm.
So he said to Akeem, he said, I do not like any game that you don't use your hands.
Mm-hmm.
And he said, what games do you guys play in Africa? Chase the monkey? He was referring to football.
Right.
So I think that looking at that, it gives me an idea that football has some kind of stigma to it when in the United States. And that's why people look at it like a sport that men should not engage in.
Mm-hmm.
But truthfully, it's the most difficult sport. It's more difficult than football, the American football.
Right.
Because it takes every ounce of muscle in your body to be able to play soccer. Every ounce of it. Like I said, it is the only sport proven scientifically to improve one's sexual libido 100%.
You didn't talk up soccer. Let's play. Let's learn some tricks.
So, let's learn some tricks.
Okay. Pass it back. Okay, passing it back.
Okay, I'm going to show you a one touch, one pass.
Okay.
One touch, one pass, it means when I pass you the ball, you got to break it, and then you give me a pass. You initiate a pass after breaking the ball.
Okay.
So I pass the ball. That is one, that's an immediate pass.
Okay.
You have to break the ball.
Break it, how do I
For
break
example,
the ball?
For example, you pass the ball to me.
Okay.
Watch, I break it. So
okay.
I put
so
the ball
So you're stopping
on,
it, right?
Yes,
okay.
I've stopped the ball totally. And then I initiate the pass. See that?
Okay.
I can move it to the next foot and I initiate the pass. And every time you do that, you displace your opponent.
Okay.
Initiate the pass. You see that?
Yeah.
Your body movement is very important in the game. You don't just play the game with your feet, you play with your mind. Once the ball comes to you, other people on the pitch are reading you. So they're trying to figure out what you want to do with the ball.
Right.
So the way you move your body tells them what you want to do. For example, pass me the ball. I've shown that I'm going this way, but that's not where I'm going. I push it this way. You see, I've displaced them because they have read my actions initially that I'm going that way.
Right, because your body
that's where they go.
That way, right.
Exactly.
Okay.
And that's how I'm going to be able to maneuver the ball, give a clear pass, and get a goal.
Okay.
Yes.
I don't think I can do it like how you did.
Oh, definitely it takes a lot of practice
right.
to be able to develop this skill. I've been playing it for a long time. So, and
what would you say your favorite position is?
I played the striker position.
Okay.
Yeah, for most of my life, I played as a striker. I could play a distributor on the midfield, but it was once in a while. I played as a striker. That's why all my best players are strikers.
Okay.
Like Ronaldo, Dalima of Brazil, Samuel Eto'o of Cameroon, very, very good strikers. Fernando Torres of Spain, Kanu Nwankwo of Nigeria, Obafemi Martins of Nigeria. Those are good strikers, people who really know how to collect the pass. The one touch, they take the ball, and they know how to move with it, and they score.
Okay.
Like that.
I don't know what you did. I tried
okay,
to do what
I'll
you did.
Okay, I'll show you another trick.
Okay.
Okay, pass the ball. You see that? I brought the ball to the same position.
Yeah.
But guess what? My opponent doesn't know what I want to do.
You just
Once
did
he
a
sees
lot.
The ball, he thinks I'm breaking it to turn. Or maybe I want to break it and go back this way. But when I break it and I go this way, I bring it back here, I've displaced him. And he's gone right behind me. And I can still initiate a pass in that same direction.
Can you do that a little bit slower? I'm gonna kick it to you slow, so
okay.
So I can see it again.
Look.
You stopped it, then you pushed it back.
And then with this other leg,
mm-hmm.
I bring it right back.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, wait, I don't, okay, wait, pass it back to me, pass it back to me. Let's see if I can do that, you did it like this, or did I go the wrong way?
Oh, you take it with this leg, you see that?
Oh,
you
gotta
push
it back.
Yes, that's how it goes.
Okay.
I just do it a little fast, so.
Hold on. Okay, wait, try again.
Okay. Let me do it slow.
Now. You stop and then you pushed it.
Okay, you want to put your foot backwards, like, pass it. You see, this leg goes backwards.
Oh.
Now, this one is standing on the same position.
Okay.
This one goes backwards. Then the ball comes this way. I bring it with this leg.
Okay.
Like so. Yeah.
Okay.
Let's go. You're doing great. You're doing great. It takes a lot of practice to do these things.
Yeah.
You need a lot of time to be able to work out with it. Football is not just about playing the ball itself.
Mm-hmm.
It's about the physical exercises that go with the game. Making sure that your ankles are flexible, which, by the way, is one of the most dangerous things that can happen to a soccer player, to have an injury
right.
on the ankle,
mm-hmm.
You know, have your body flexible, and then you'll be able to play.
Okay.
And as normal as any other game you've ever learned, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah. So,
okay.
I want to thank you for allowing me the opportunity to show you a few things about football and share football history with you. And I hope that from now on you refer to it as football instead of soccer.
Thank you. I learned a lot of things I did not know.
Okay.
Uh-oh.
All right.
I might have to pick up a soccer ball when I get home.
Okay.
Oh, let me not do that again.
See, you take that. That's one pass. That's it.
Sorry, can't use your hands in soccer.
You cannot
I forgot.
Use your hands in soccer.
I forgot.
So, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much. It's been great to have you back.